Hey everyone, it's Dave here, and welcome to... I don't know how to spell it. VisiFeed? VZFeed? Fuck it. VisiFeed overview. That's my two cents to the spelling bee. I think this is actually the first time that I'm doing an intro to the fitness app, because normally those apps would just release out of the blue with no mentions or trailers in general. This is the first time that I actually know the date, know everything. But with those applications, it's always hilarious. So for me, it's pure entertainment to watch it how it resolves. So what do we have here this time? So VisiFeed is workout cardio application. I'd say mostly cardio, yeah, because people are just mostly working out in one place, either with the hands or legs. So I'm assuming it's simulating all the movement-based workout gear, such as bikes or, I don't know, legs. I don't know any sports gear, so just everything that makes you travel, I guess. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be mostly comparing this to Holodia, and mostly because the premise is very similar. They're putting you in an environment to work out, but in a way that shouldn't be boring visually. Like, you're not staying at the wall 2 hours straight and do nothing. Here you can actually enjoy the scenery at your home, of course, and just feel the fake breeze of virtual reality. I think the main difference between this and Holodia is that you're actually seeing real places, which I had the most grip with, the graphical aspect. Because if you're doing a simulation of the environment or anything in general for workouts, it has to make sense. And VisiFeed seems like to be borrowing the Google Street Maps, actually. That's very smart, because you're not essentially generating a new environment to play, but rather just putting the existing ones and make your magic with movement of traveling the actual real distances. I like this concept way better, especially because you don't feel then that you're in a game, meaning that it actually feels like a real workout, which I feel most of the workout applications are actually missing that. Like, virtual reality is fine for gaming and stuff, but I feel like for workout specifically should be like a semi-virtual reality, if that makes sense even. Unless you wanna work out with anime waifus, like, you do you. Trailer is absolutely hilarious. For some reason they essentially use a green screen, but not only the environments, but also the houses that they play in. There's no shadows there, they're actually putting a green screen simulation of like they would be in their home spaces. Like, hilarious. I'm not a specialist, obviously. I don't have a bike. I'm just gonna be running on my bed, I suppose so. But I wanna see if the execution of the scenery in between images from Google Maps, because essentially it's not videos, it's images. So there has to be some kind of transition between each section, I believe. And I'm curious how fluid it's gonna be, and if it won't be very immersion breaking or just annoying to play. So can't wait to fall off my bed. Bet you didn't expect me now here. Alright, so I just finished the recording sessions for today. I mean, you can basically tell, right? I tried numerous times with VisiFeed, but it just refuses to cooperate, so I can't be fucked. And the recordings were very haphazard. Like, I tried to record something, but then it got cancelled by the application. Like, it's just a huge mess, so I can't be bothered, and I'm just gonna do like a spoken overview now, I guess. From the footage that I salvaged or whatever, you can see like VisiFeed is pretty much you're like on a podium, whether you're playing with a bike or just like with your own feet. You're traveling basically through the environments that are cycling through the scenery, and you can set it up like whenever you want. I was like in Paris as a tutorial, and that was interesting, but like I feel like sceneries with open landscapes work well because there's a discrepancy between a 360 photo and the landscape that you're moving. Like, there's a weird shift on the sides, as you can see. But the application itself is pretty fun. Like, I can definitely tell that people would enjoy it if you have like a stationary bike at homes and they're exercising there. I'm not sure if there's like any music or just like anything. I didn't do anything past the actual tutorial because just the whole membership process and processing the info is pretty much broken. Like, I could not pass anything because the application does not verify shit. So the whole release is just pretty much screwed over for me. So this is what it is. Like, I don't care that much, but the core like gameplay I tried out was fine with all the moving system and the immersion. Sometimes, depends on the environment, it's gonna be very much pixelated. Like, those are like, you know, 360 environments, but Quest 2 has so high quality panel that if they would use like a photogrammetry from real fishing VR or something, you wouldn't notice anything. But visually it is kind of like realistic, but not to the point to fool you that you're still in VR. So whatever, just quick video about it.